name. Let's lift his name on high. Come on, Zion, we praise our King. Let's celebrate.
for real. I'm excited, man. I got a cousin on each side of the church today. Look at that. I don't know how to feel today. I'm excited. Wave at somebody on the other side. Tell them, how you doing? Good to see you today. You know, when you came in, you went right to your seat. You didn't go down the right side and then cross over to the left side, so you didn't see them over there. So, come on, Mama Wade. Oh, look at Mama Wade looking so lovely. She's got her spring colors on. Come on, tell God, thank you. Amen. Oh, Lord, the sun is shining. The weather is nice today. And we going to give God the praise. Now, I'm going to tell y'all now, we getting ready to get started. Ambassadors, Deacon Cersei, Deacon Curtis, God bless you, appreciate you. Listen, if it gets warm, because we do got to warm, if it gets warm, y'all pop them windows open, get your fans out, take your jacket off. Amen. Put your hair in a ponytail if you have to. Amen. Hopefully we won't be here too long. But if y'all get to jumping and dancing and running and shouting and praising God like you know how, then the temperature might increase. Amen. So we want to make sure that we are okay. Amen. And we are comfortable. Well, listen, this is the day that the Lord has made. There's no house like God's house. There are no people like God's people. And I don't know about you, but I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to APC at 12:30. Amen. And then we're going to give God the... How many of y'all were on Bible app this morning? Just wave at me. Let me see. There you... Come on. Let me see you. Then we've already had church. We've already gotten inspiration. We've already received information and instruction to help us to continue on in the name of the Lord. Amen. Come on. We're getting ready to make some announcements on today. Yeah, come on. We're going to make some announcements. Amen. Sister Naomi, she's got an announcement. She's coming. I want you to get that together. Yeah, since they already asked you, you might as well go ahead and save it and have it ready to go for the next couple of weeks. Amen. I think Lady K was somewhere. I think she had an announcement. Amen. I think she had an announcement as well. We're going to get to those. Amen. Amen. Sister Tasha, good to see you. Amen. Good to see you, Sister Tasha. Sister Tasha praying for Mama Lee and Sister Tiffany. I didn't get an update. Is Tiff home? Is she all? She's doing all right? She's doing all right? Amen. Thank God. Praying for her. She is home. Amen. Praying for Mama Lee. Amen. As she's continuing to recover. Let's contact Mama Wade. Let's pray for Mama Wade and Papa Wade. Amen. The passing of her brother-in-law, Papa Wade's brother. Amen. Elder Shanice Payton and Brother Derwin are here on today. Let's continue to pray for Elder Shanice and their family. Amen. As the father was just funeralized, the patriarch of that family was just funeralized from this room on Friday. And I want to say thank you to each and every one of you that came out to support, amen, the family. I appreciate it. It made my heart feel good to see members caring for members. Members caring for members. Members caring for members. We are a church that serves each other. We are a church that serves one another. So at this time, amen, Sister Naomi, she's already here. We've got one announcement for Holy Healthy. If they get the Holy Healthy announcement ready, it's going to probably be a little out of order. So just keep scrolling and going back and going forward until we get to where we need to. But I want y'all to get ready because next Saturday, I want y'all to get ready for the Holy Healthy kickoff and receive Sister Naomi Tucker at this time with that announcement.
Praise the Lord, everyone. On the last Saturday of this month, April 27th, at 12 o'clock noon, Holy Healthy presents From Pain to Power to Purpose to Peace. This will be a panel group discussion questioning the normality of abnormality. This discussion is a follow-up from the two previous presentations from Sister Harvey, which we all enjoyed and got a lot of information from her, as well as critical thinking to think about where we are on our journey and could relate to hers. The panelists are all former members consisting of pastors. We have Apostle Denise Milben Williams, Pastor Kermit DeLashment, and mental health specialist Sister Tara Keisha Hammond. So please put the date on your calendar and meet us there. You all be blessed.
That's Saturday, April the 27th. So for those of you all that have not been on Bible application, then you all have been missing the holy, healthy information that has been rolling out, and we want you to join us on Bible application so that you can catch up to what is going on, and that is what is going to make this particular Saturday, April the 27th, so important, because we want you to come out. We don't just want you to come and shout and dance on Sunday, but we want you to come out and be healed and made whole, amen, every opportunity that we do have. All right, and at this time, our women's ministry leader is coming with a special announcement, and then after her, receive our director of our Seniors on the Move, the one and only Dr. Mother Brendan.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Next Sunday is a big day here at our park. It is Lady K Day, and we are celebrating our Lady K. And so we want everyone to be ready to bless our First Lady on next Sunday. Just get excited. She is a mighty woman of God who works diligently in the house of the Lord. And hopefully you all receive your emails so you know what you got to do. But be prepared to celebrate all day, because we're going to have a good time celebrating Lady K. Amen. Also, come on, Mother Brenda. If you are signing up for the summer book club, meet me out there today. $13. This book is called Set Apart, and we're going to take a deeper dive into our walk with the Lord.
Amen. 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 You know, we're moving at the park. Everything is going on, from the women's, from the holy, healthy, and now it's the Seniors on the Move. APC Morgan Park. It's springtime 2024. This means it's time for APC Morgan Park Seniors on the Move to come back out Thursday, April the 25th, 12 to 3, where we're gonna be excited. And I don't know if you notice, I don't have my cane today. I do have my brace on, but God is doing a mighty work in this here body, and I know if he's doing it for me, what he'll do for you. So come on out for a time of fellowship, food, and fun. We look forward to seeing you here. A light lunch will be served. So behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. Psalms 133:1. Because we build this here Seniors on the Move on the Word of God. So we looking for you, you and you, 55 and up, that can and will. And those of you that are retired, bring your husband, bring your wife. We're looking for you. It's not just for the women. It's for the brothers as well. In Jesus' name, much love.
Let me ask this question. Don't be ashamed. How many of y'all in the room are over the age of 55? Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Be proud. Raise it high. Let some of you got both hands up. Somebody's jumped up and stood up. So what she's telling you is that means, amen. Sister Angie just came in. Sister Angie, wave your hand at us. Sister Angie, wave at us. Amen. That's right. She falls right in. She's in that category as well. Amen. So listen, that means on those Thursdays, those of you all that are available during the day, right, we want you all to come out for fellowship. We want you all to come out for friendship and to receive information and inspiration, because we always have inspiration. We always have information and resources that are available to seniors for whatever it is that you may need. Everybody stand to your feet all over the building. Stand to your feet all over the building. We're getting ready to pray. Elder Sonia, come on if you would. Just before we do that, I want to do this though. Maybe y'all missed it. Did y'all hear what Mother Nash just said? Dr. Mother Nash. She just testified. I should have had two or three people testify on the day. But y'all come next Sunday. Maybe we'll have y'all testify. Let me ask this question. Anybody else got a testimony? Just wave at me. Say, I got a testimony. The Lord did. The Lord's been good. High five me from your seat right there. Say, I got a testimony. I wish you would let me tell it, but since you ain't going to let me tell it, I'm going to just high five you one more time. High five me again right there. All right. You ain't got to tell us, but you can tell somebody. You can tell anybody, you can tell everybody. She just testified and said, y'all didn't even notice today. She said, I ain't got my cane today. Come on, tell God thank you for Sister Nash that she ain't got a cane today. And this is what I thank God for. I thank God for the opportunity for us to recognize and realize the small things. Look at your neighbor and say, I thank God for the small things. Those of y'all watching online, type in the comments, I thank God for the small things. On the way to the magnificent, on the way to the majestic, look at your neighbor and say, don't forget about the small things. In the process to what God is going to do in your life that is magnificent, in the process of what God is going to do in your life that is majestic, in the process of what God is doing in your life that is magnanimous. Don't forget about the small things. The Bible says it like this. Here's my first message for today, my first lesson. Y'all sound good over there. Thank you. I promise I feel like I'm going to get happy. We might just keep going and have church. Here's the first lesson on today. I want y'all to catch. Look at your neighbor and say, don't forget the small things. Don't forget the small things. Don't forget the small things. Type it in the comments. Don't forget the small things. She said, today, I ain't got a cane. No. Listen, she didn't testify today about the miracle of healing that she's still believing and we're believing with you that God can and will do. That wasn't a testimony today. That don't mean that's not a testimony that's loading. Y'all type it in the comments. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, my testimony is still loading. It's still loading. My testimony is loading. It's loading. It's loading. It's loading. It's loading. It's loading. It's loading. Somebody caught that, huh? That's right. I told y'all last week where two or three are gathered together. There's enough of us in here to agree that we will have a testimony after we come out of this. But in the process, I have yet to experience what is magnificent. I have yet to experience what is miraculous. But if I've got any Bible readers in here that can high five me from your seat and get happy with me when I say this, even though the magnificent and the majestic hasn't happened yet, is there anybody in here besides Bill Ellis that can praise God? Because the Bible says that God loads us with benefits. Daily. I hear Bishop E. Daily. Run it down your row and say daily. Every day. So here's what I want to encourage you all on today. Keep praising God for the majestic. Keep believing God for the miraculous. But grab a neighbor by the hand. I feel church now. Grab a neighbor by the hand and say, neighbor, on today, we're going to praise our God for the benefits that he's given us today. Now ask your neighbor, what did he do for you today? What did he do for you today? He woke me up this morning, started me on my way, put food on my table, helped me see the dawning of a brand new day. What did God do for you today? I dare you, get out your seat and go testify to two people, only two, not three, just two. Go testify to two people and tell them what God did for you today. What did God do for you today? What did God do for you today? Did he touch your body? Did he touch your mind? Did he touch your spirit? What did God do for you today? That's it, that's it. What did God do for you today? If you know God did something good for you today, just wave your hands and say, he did it for me today. Wave your hand and say, God did it for me today. Type it in the comments. God did it for me today. He loaded me with benefits today. And tomorrow, I expect new mercies every morning. Tuesday, I expect new mercy. Wednesday, I expect new. Thursday, I expect blessings, benefits, and benevolence every day. On my way to something majestic, on my way to something miraculous, I'm going to praise God for the small things. Hey! Lift your hands all over the building and lift your mouth and give God a great praise for the benefits that he's loaded you with. He did it for you. He kept your body. He kept your mind. He kept your soul. He kept your spirit. Now give a great God a great praise. You've been better to us than we've been to ourselves. We give you glory, Lord. We give you glory, Lord. Come on, give God the glory. Give God the praise. Give him glory. Give him the honor. Give him the praise. Give him the praise. Give him the glory. Give God the honor. Give God the praise. Give God the praise. Give God the glory. Give God the honor. Give God the praise. That's due his name. That's it. Give God the glory. Give God the honor. Give him the glory. Give him the honor. Give him the praise. Give God the praise. Give God the praise. God has touched your body. God has kept your mind. Come on and give God the praise. Give him the glory. Give him the honor. Give him the praise. And bless God's name. Come on, everybody, give God the glory. The honor. Woo! Altar right now. If you've got a pressing need, if you've got an urgent request, I want you to come to the altar now. Come now. Come now. I grew up in the old church that said, while the water is being troubled. Elder Sonia's getting ready to lead us in prayer. Come on, only you know what you need God to do for you. Only you know your situation. Only you know your circumstance. Only you know your condition. That's it. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on. Come on. Three of y'all need to come on up here. You're reluctant for some reason. I don't know. You said I should, but I'm not. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, grab the hand of a neighbor that believes God with you, that believes God for you. Look at that neighbor's hand that you're holding and say, neighbor, I believe God for you. I believe God with you. I believe God as you. I'm praying for you. I'm praying with you. And I'm praying as you. You just stepped into intercession. Keep playing, Richard. Keep playing real soft. Keep playing. You just stepped into intercession. You just stepped into intercession. You don't know what your brother, your sister, your neighbor is going through. Even with what they told you, you don't know what they didn't tell you. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Let me teach you about intercession because you thought you knew what it was, but let me upgrade your theology. Intercession does not mean I'm praying for you. Intercession does not mean that I stand in the gap and intercede for you. True intercession is when I pray as you. It's when the Spirit allows me to connect to what you're going through and I transcend in the Holy Ghost from praying for you. You thought you knew what intercession was. But I'm thanking God today that God is sending intercessors into your life. Ooh, my, oh, my God. Oh. So that when you are weak, and you can't lift your own voice to pray for yourself. I want you to know on today that God has somebody. Somebody prayed for me. You're holding the hand of my God today. Somebody. Thank you. on their mind. I want you to start praying right now. Open your spirit and allow the Holy Ghost to show you who you need to pray for. While you're praying for somebody else, while you're interceding, God has someone interceding for you. You are not alone. You are not praying for yourself. You are not praying by yourself. Ooh, I feel the Holy Ghost power of God in this room. You're praying for somebody else to be healed, and somebody's praying for you to be healed. And watch the healer show up. You're praying for a breakthrough and a miracle, and somebody is praying for your breakthrough and your miracle, and watch it happen. Woo! Hallelujah. Miracles are coming. Breakthrough is taking place. Supernatural release and relief. Elder Sonia is getting ready to pray this prayer of agreement. You are holding hands with somebody that you are agreeing that God's best will manifest in our reality. After Elder Sonia prays, we're going to worship and give praise unto our God. Because we prayed, we believe, and it shall be done.
In the name of Jesus. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Father God, we thank you and we praise you, God, as we have gathered around this altar today, God. Father, as we are praying for our brothers and sisters, as they are, Lord God, you heard what the command was today, Lord Jesus. Father God, we thank you and we praise you. God, we bind our faith with their faith today, oh God. We come to let the enemy know that we're not afraid of him. He shall not attack us. He won't attack our children. He won't attack our finances. He won't attack our homes in the name of Jesus. He won't attack our wives and our husbands in the name of Jesus. He won't attack the grandchildren in the name of Jesus. He won't attack the pastor and the first lady, oh God. Father God, we come boldly before the throne of grace this morning. God, we want to tell you thank you for just what you're doing, God. There's no God like the God that we serve. God, we want the enemy to know that we are victorious in the name of Jesus. Yes, God, we stand and practice. We stand with our brothers and sisters today. We ask that you go to the hospital and touch back Brother Tyrone today, Lord God. Father, we ask that you will touch Mama Lee, God. All the senior saints and the ones that are not represented today, Lord God. Father, come on in this place today, God. 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 Take over, Lord. Take over, God. Let your spirit fall afresh, God. God, we worship your name today. We praise your name. God, we thank you. Yes. Mercy, God. Mercy, God. Mercy, God. Mercy, God. Breakthrough. God, we thank you. Healing. We thank you. Father, reconciliation, we thank you. God, Somebody needs to repent. Somebody needs to repent. God is waiting to hear you repent. You will receive your breakthrough. Repent in Jesus' name. God, I thank you. God, I thank you. God, I thank you. God, I thank you. God, I thank you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. That's a good place for a hallelujah, hallelujah. That's a great place for a hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I dare you to bless God for a moment. I dare you just to magnify the name of Jesus for a moment. Your name above all name, God. Your name above all name, God. Hallelujah. Hey, we bless your name, Lord. Hey, and we worship you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship you. Is anybody else here to worship him this afternoon? For who you are, yeah. I dare you to lift your hands and worship him for a minute. I dare you to clap your hands and worship. I dare you to just open up your mouth, lift your voice and worship. Because we worship you. We sing hallelujah. Is anybody else here to sing it? Hallelujah. We worship you. Hey, for who you are. Hey. I'm not stalling. I'm just taking a minute just to see how we're feeling this afternoon. It's a beautiful day outside. So I think that we owe God some praise. We're in here to experience it. That means he woke us up this morning, started us on our way, put us in our right mind. I may not have all my mind, but it's at least still my right mind. I could have been somewhere else, so that's why I worship you. I sing hallelujah. We worship you for who you are. Hey. And if you're with me, would you say, for you are good. Hey.
Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory.
Put your hands right. Hey, APC, y'all here to worship the Lord this morning? Come on, let's all sing together. Lord, you are good, say.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy enduring forever.
Y'all got it. Come on, sing along, say.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy enduring forever.
Hey, let's sing it again, say.
Lord, you are good,
playing good today, band. Say, Lord, you're
Lord,
good.
You are good and your mercy enduring forever.
Come on, I need help, all of them. Say, people.
People from every nation and tongue, from generation to generation.
We
worship you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We worship you. A good God. Just look at the person next to you. Tell him he's a good God.
A good
tell
God.
Him he's been good to me.
Good
He's been real good to me. Come on, now make it a prayer. Lord, you are good, say.
Lord, you are good and your mercy is enduring forever.
Did you say?
Lord, you are good and your mercy is enduring forever.
Did you say?
Lord, you are good and your mercy.
The band is playing all right today. Come on. Now this is your invitation, people.
People from every nation,
from generation. That means from young to old.
Pastor Bill has been on something on Tuesday nights. He asked us a question on Tuesday. He said, who is Jesus and who is he to you? Just take a minute. Just take a minute. Don't talk to nobody just for a minute. Just think about it for yourself for a moment. Who has God been to you in your life? You don't even got to look back over your whole life. Just look at this week. Somebody said, I was sick this time last week, but here I am today. Mama Brenda said, I was on a walker once upon a time, but here I am today. Somebody said, you know what? I suffered something this week, but God still pulled me out. Somebody had a bill. They didn't know how I was going to get paid this week. I'm somebody. I'm somebody. But God came through. That's why I say that you are
good.
Yeah.
All the time.
Yeah.
All the time.
You are good.
You
yeah.
are good.
Yeah. Okay, now this time look at somebody. This time look at somebody. Pastor Bill told us something else earlier. He said, I'm a testimony. Just tell somebody one more time what you're testifying about. I know you told the two people already, but tell somebody else. What are you testifying about today? Maybe he woke you up this morning and that's good enough. I didn't know if I was gonna get up. My back was hurting and I got up and I'm still moving. I don't know what your testimony is, but I guarantee that whatever it is, you can say you are
good. Hey. All the time.
Hey.
All the time. You are good. You are good.
Hey.
All the time.
Yeah.
You are good.
Now put your hands right. Hey. Everybody clap your hands. Everybody clap your hand. Say everybody clap your hand. Hey, one more time. You are good.
You are good.
Hey.
All the time. All the time. You are good.
Hey.
You are good. All the time.
And all the time.
All the time.
You are good.
Come on,
say Lord, you're good. Lord, you're good.
Lord, you are good and your mercy enduring forever.
I dare you to lift your hands and make it a prayer this morning. I dare you not to sing it to me, but to sing it to God today. I dare you to sing it to the Holy Spirit today. Say, Lord, you're good.
Lord, you are good and your mercy enduring forever.
Say, Lord, you're good.
Lord, you are good and your mercy enduring forever.
Say, Lord, you're good.
Everybody, lift your voice and sing that. Lord, you are.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever.
A little softer, Rich. Let me hear the voices. Come on.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever.
Sing it.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever.
Y'all be quiet. Let's hear the voices say.
Lord, you are.
Say, Lord, you are good. Sing it.
Yes, you are God.
Sing it, church. Let me hear you say, Lord, you are. That's your song.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever.
That's your song. Sing it. Y'all, let them say.
Yes.
Come on, sing that all week long. That's your song. Sing it. Thank you, Pastor Zeke. Thank you, praise team. We appreciate you. But y'all say it, Lord. Come on, sing it one more time. Say, Lord, you
Lord,
are good.
You are good and your mercy endure it forever.
Say, forever. Grateful to experience the mercies of God. Come on, clap your hands and lift your voice and just say, God, I thank you for mercy. I didn't hear you say, God, I thank you for mercy. Those of y'all watching online, type in the comments, God, I thank you for mercy. Everybody in the room, say it one more time. God, I thank you for mercy. Mercies fail not, or his compassions fail not, and his mercy is new every morning. And we're grateful that we serve a faithful God. Look at somebody and tell them, I serve a faithful God. Type in the comments, I serve a faithful God. I serve a faithful God. I serve a faithful. Amen. Turn with me in your Bibles on today. We're going to be in the book of Matthew, and we're also going to be in the book of John. Thank you, musicians. Thank you, worshipers. Thank you for leading us into the presence of God.
We're grateful for what God is doing and for what God has done. And do me a favor, just before we move into the message, those of you all watching online, those of you all in the room, look at somebody and say, neighbor, thank you for interceding for me. How many of you all were on TNT on Tuesday? Let me ask a question. How many of you all were not on TNT Tuesday night? Raise your hand so I can see. Hi. Let me see. I'm counting. Raise it up higher. Let me keep it up higher. Hold it up high. Higher. No, keep it up. Y'all, I haven't got to your section yet. Keep your hand up. We are an obedient church, aren't we? Amen. If you were not on TNT this past Tuesday, raise your hand high. Higher, Sister Robin. Get the kink out your elbow. That's what Bishop E would say. Yeah, see, you should have been on TNT, then we wouldn't have had this issue. All right, put your hands down. One more time, those of you all that were not on TNT, take a deep breath and then raise your hand high. Y'all tried to, you got, ooh, y'all doing that. Get it back up there. Come on, high. Let me see. I got to look at this side now. Higher. Lift your hands higher. All right, those of you all that were on TNT, raise both hands. Because you got the bit. Come on, look at that. See that? Woo, my God, look at that. Woo. Ooh. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Woo. I promise you, something just happened that was so amazing. I'm going to share it with y'all in a minute. So watch this. Let's get right into it. So I'm going to pick up from where I left off on TNT. So those of you all that didn't have your hands up, those of you all that only had one hand up, rather, then I'm going to be a blessing to you to help catch you up. Those of you all that had both hands up, this will be a bit of a reminder, refresher, in case you forgot what we were talking about. Whew, but I'm going to show y'all something. I'm going to show you. Come on. Holy Ghost, activate. Boy, Holy Spirit, activate. Come on, let's go then, Brother Blunt. I'm glad. Thank you. All right, who's got? I want this side to get Matthew 16 and 15. This side. Thank you, Dr. Mother Nass. This side get Matthew 16, 15. It doesn't matter. You can get whichever version. Thank you. I'm glad you asked, though. And this side get John 20 and 26. This side get Matthew chapter 16. This side get John 20. Just get the chapter, and then we'll get there. Thank you, Sister Cometa. That's right. Y'all get John 20. This side get Matthew 16. Those of you all watching online, let's do it like this. I'm going to say half of y'all, if your birthday ends with an even digit, you get Matthew 16, those of you all watching online. And if your birthday ends with an odd digit, then you get John 20, all right? You get John 20. So we're going to ping pong between Matthew 16 and John 20 for the rest of this month. And I'm going to also, the Holy Spirit has illuminated that this is going to help lead us into Holy Healthy Month, which is the month of May, which will actually kick off a week early, because that's how serious we are here at APC Morgan Park about you being whole, about you being holy, and you being healthy. Thank you. I'm glad I got some amens. It felt real good. Here's my topic for today. How many of y'all know what it is? What are we talking about this month? Thank you. Some of y'all are listening. And what's the topic? That's the theme. That's great. I'm so glad y'all said that. Thank you. That's okay. And what's the topic? I like it. Come on. See there? Come on, Elder Payton. I see you on the front row. You go back through your notes, baby. And Dr. Mother Nash been saved long enough now she done forgot the song. Boom, 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 boom. Who is he? And what? Richard, I'm going to send you that one next week, all right? So just the baseline is all. Rick, Zeke, get your bass, all right? You look at your neighbor and ask him, who is he? And what is he to you? My cousin Derwin is here today. Good to see you, Derwin, man. Look, man, Derwin. You remember that song, don't you? we about that age, right? We about that age. I got my big cousin here today. We about that age. Remember, it was a song that Bill Withers wrote a song. Come on, see that, brother? But he just, he didn't want y'all to know he knew the song. But when I said Bill Withers, he said, his baby leaped. He said, amen. He said, amen. That's right. Bill Withers asked a question back, I was born in 77. It was between, I believe, 77 or 79. I'm not sure what year that particular album came out. But he asked a question and said, who is he and what is he to you? The query that was being investigated with the title of this song and the circumstance that presented themselves in this challenging love triangle is that there is now a man who has presented himself in the equation of your life. And by virtue of his activity, his behavior, or his contribution, this man now has your attention. There were a group of people back in over 2,000 years ago who were, some of them were industrious businessmen, some of them were trying to figure out and find their way. Some of them had careers. They were different ages, different experiences, different educational backgrounds, different professional backgrounds. But all of the sudden, this dude shows up seemingly out of nowhere, and he points to at least one of them as he's walking down the street and says, man, them some fresh Jordans you got on. What you do for a living? I do a little bit of this, do a little bit of that. I hustle a little bit here, hustle a little bit there. Wherever I can in this oppressive society and culture that the Romans are now dominating and colonizing, I just do the best I can with what I got to fit in where I can. So it's like, well, bro, you whatever your hustle is, it must be pretty sweet because, you know, them is like special edition J's you got on. We ain't seen them. You got air bubbles in your sandals. I'm just, come on, walk with me. We coloring the text. How you pull that off? You got the double rubber cushion. Ain't even heard of rubber. Rubber? What's that? Wait a minute. Hey, hold on. But here's what I need you to do. Not only I see you know how to hustle. I see your hustle is real. I see you even got some people that work with you, some people that follow you. You be like, hey, listen, what y'all doing today? All right, well, listen, grab your hooks. Y'all want to go down to the bank with me? Jump on my boat, we're going to go catch some fish. Y'all ain't got nothing else to do. So come on, go with me. Jesus is like, hey, to at least one of them, I'm not going to talk about all 12 today, I don't have that kind of time, but to at least one of them, he said, hey, yo, why don't you come rock with me? You think your hustle is legit? Think your hustle is real? I see you got folk following you. Evidently, you got some influence. Evidently, your mouthpiece, your word game makes an impact on people, and they follow you. So I see you got a little fishing business. How's that going for you? I go out on the deep sometime and I hustle. Sometime I hustle on the shallow end, depending on what I'm trying to get. So it's just like, all right, well, listen. I see where you hustling. Sometime you go deep. Sometime you go shallow. That depends on what kind of fish you're trying to catch. Well, I'm here to fish, but I'm here to catch human beings. I'm here to catch human beings who were once taught the way. Human beings who should know the way. But human beings who have been encumbered with vast amounts of information that has started to challenge what they believe and how they act on those beliefs. And so now this dude is looking at him probably like y'all looking at me right now. Huh? Yeah. I know about your fishing business. I heard about it. I've been in these streets. I done asked around. They like Peter, he do his thing, He got a good hustle going. He got a little attitude. He's not the kind of boss that you always want to work for, work with. But, Peter do know how to get that money. He do know where the fish are. He know when to go deep. He know when to go shy. Peter know the hustle. We try to work with him, but Peter got it. Man, Peter, listen. Peter, he got another side to him. Anybody else in here, you got another side to you that... Lord, come on, I got some, thank you. I got an honest church wave at me in here. There's a side that you thank God that you've been delivered from. Come on, thank you, Elder. Now I got one high five. You ought to get up out your seat and say, God, I thank you for delivering me. That way I know who I'm talking about. Let me say it again. You, get up. You need to get out your seat and say, God, come on, tell God, there's another side of you that we don't want to see come out. There's a pre-salvation Peyton. There's a pre-salvation Foster. There's a pre-salvation, there's a pre-salvation Patterson. But you ought to thank God. I didn't want to call your name, but you didn't stand up, so I... And so Jesus picks 12 people to follow him to carry out his mission. I'm already in the lesson. I'm going to break this up, and I'm going to give you bits and pieces and portions, and I'm going to give you dots, and then we'll connect them all by the time I conclude this series. But here's where I want to move over into this next portion to say, if this question is rhetorical, it's introspective, but if Jesus encountered you since you've been in church, this ain't your first church. This ain't your only church. But since you've been in church, since you've been in the church culture, since you have been a participating part of the faith community, my question to you on today, before I move into this next portion, is to ask this. If Jesus was to pick you, what would he have to contend with? What is it about your person and personality that would prevent you from being an effective tool in the kingdom? I do, but not today. We got to talk about that for the rest of this week. But thank you. Thank you, Brother Blunt, because that is, I want you to answer it not out loud, but answer it to yourself. This is a question of introspection. I said that, didn't I? I'm not listening to myself, right? Okay, that's all good. This is a question of retrospection, right? Good. So thank you. That means y'all paying attention. Thank you, Brother Blunt. That means you listening. Ask yourself. Now, I'm not literally Jesus. Bill Ellis, talking about me, pastor of ABC Morgan Park, father of Amory and Eden, husband of Kellen, youngest of the Ellis clan, last of the Ellis name, under the house of Willie. I am not literally Jesus, but my daily striving is to be like Christ. I know what I've had to work through, what I've had to work with, and what I've had to work on that would make me, thank you, Holy Ghost, a worthy follower of Yeshua HaMashiach. That's for my black Hebrew Israelites that's watching. Yeah, it's all good. I'll talk to y'all too. One of them was here last Sunday. Y'all out. See, y'all don't know. That's what I'm talking to everybody. We global. We internationally recognized and locally accepted. Come on. I'm asking you, those of you all watching online, thank you, Dr. Dewey Smith. Lend me the cinema of your cerebral cortex as I paint this picture for you. If I showed up as one who was rumored to be immaculately concepted, but y'all know my mom and daddy, so y'all know it ain't immaculacy, right? Human beings being human. 50% of one, 50% of another, 100% of me. If Jesus chose me today, there are some things that Jesus would not have to contend with if Jesus had chose me before today. Now, I ain't going to tell you what day, because I've been pastoring this church for 7 years coming in May. And that day may not precede those 7 years. Thank you, bro. I got one witness in here on today. And so, since I've recognized that what God has done in my life, what God has done through my life, and what God is doing as God is working in my life allows me to be able to look in the mirror and say, things I used to do, I don't do I know I got a church in here that's old enough to remember when we used to say that. And places I used to go, I don't go. But I've neither forgotten how to do them, nor have I forgotten where I can do them at. Some of us, if the truth be told, are living holy by circumstance. Because you can't do what you want to do. Oh, you could try, but somebody, I heard you. Oh, yes, I can. You can try it if you want to. You try it if you want to, lest a worse thing come upon you. Go on out there and try the electric slide like you used to. Oh, I can try it if you want. Listen, I can't electric slide. I got bad knees. Let me just. That's all I got. I can't. That's all I got. That's all I got. I can't. So some of us got to be honest about the fact that, watch this, I'm going to help y'all out. Some of us have to be honest that there are some things that we still need to overcome. Some of us don't participate in certain, I'll just use this loosely. Let me fast forward through this. Some of us don't participate in certain moral infractions, whether they may be public or private, whether it's in a discretion or indiscretion. It may be immoral, but it's not illegal. And some of us just don't participate anymore simply because we can't do it like we used to. We don't get the same level of enjoyment. Does not mean we don't get enjoyment. It just means now I kind of pick and choose. So I'll do a little bit here and there every now and then. Juxtaposed against, let's fast forward all the way back to a few weeks ago where we just had a radical, wonderful public baptism, a display of people making their public confession of their inward belief, their confession. And now they have said, because I have accepted the radical, redeeming, reconciling, and transformative work of Christ in my life, there is an action put forth that says things I used to do. But just like some of the people that got baptized for the first time versus some of those that got re-baptized, I've been walking with the Lord long enough that, quite frankly, I've become a bit stagnant. I've become a bit complacent. And yeah, things I used to do, I don't do no more. But the truth is, I just don't do them like I used to do. Ooh. I may not go where I used to go to do what I used to do, but I found a little alternative in the middle. Watch this. That satiates my flesh, but does not glorify my Creator. Well, here's the lesson on today. Jesus chooses this guy who's struggling what he's going through. And in the book of Matthew 15, he gets challenged. Jesus asks a question that challenges both the perception and the perspective of those who have been following him. But here's what's so significant in this text. Watch this. If y'all been in church long enough, you heard about this. But Jesus had crowds that follow him. Jesus had multitudes. Multitudes, multitude. Everybody say divine multiplication. There was a multiplicity of individuals that followed Jesus from afar as a crowd. In other words, it's like saying it's Sunday morning and everybody come to church on Sunday. Just showed up because it's Sunday. Some of you all are here because of your relationship. Some of you all are here because of ritual. And then some of you are trying to figure out, why am I here? Not just in church, but why do I exist? What have I been placed on earth for? Well, unfortunately, we don't have the time to unpack all of that for you as individuals, but yet and still, if you open your spirit to hear what the Holy Ghost will say to you, he that hath an ear, let them do what? What the Spirit has said to the church. You will hear what it is for your life. So on today, I want you to catch this. Jesus has multitudes. Then Jesus has 70 that he sends out as disciples. 35 groups of two. Then Jesus has 12. And in this 12, he's got three. Now, in this group of 12, he asks all of them a question, and they give different responses. But we see magnified in the book of Matthew the response of one, Peter, who gives us apostolic Pentecostals our formula for entering into the faith community. Be clear on that. It's Peter that gives us, this group, our formula on how to enter into the faith community. So it's this Peter, the one that speaks up because of his personality. I'm going to let Evangelist Foster talk about that because I'm not a professional. I'm not qualified. But what I am qualified to do is discuss the parallel between what he goes through psychologically and spiritually. He is having what is called a psycho-spiritual illumination. We know who Jesus is. Because we were told. We know who Jesus is because we have our personal experience. Peter. Remember a song we used to sing in church? Everybody don't know who Jesus. Everybody. You know why everybody don't? They didn't know. And here's Jesus saying, y'all been with me for the last 3 years. Peter, I took you from hustling. I took you from being, I just learned this later. It's called dog whistle language. In other words, I took you from being a thug in the streets. Because that's how Roman colonization saw your ethnicity. While all you were doing was doing the best you could to take care of your family. But because the colonizing government did not see you as a contributing individual, they saw you as one of those thugs who hung out with Jesus. And when you get challenged, your thuggery shows up. Y'all want to talk about that a little bit? When the people who are being oppressed are consistently challenged, consistently disrespected, and consistently disregarded, sooner or later. Is there anybody in here like me that been in church long enough or you've been black long enough to understand a black colloquialism that says I'm sick and tired of being, come here Fannie Lou Hamer, let me talk to you. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired of being oppressed by colonization, by the dominant culture when all I'm trying to do is make a living for my family and serve the God of my salvation. So So in the words of Chris Rock, good to see you, Minister Mona. I don't agree with what Peter did, but I understand. Because when the Roman centurions have now cornered the man that took him off his job, changed his mentality, and showed him a better way of living. Listen, let me say it to you like this. Let me say it to you like this. Let me say it to you like this. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I hear you. Bill Ellis, I started this lesson off with this. Call Richard. Zeke, come play. I'm getting ready to close. Bring me down. Soft music. I'm done. Since I've been pastoring this church, I've come to understand who I am. I'm going to understand who God is. And in this journey, I am appreciating the development of understanding who I am in God and who God is in me. So because I have accepted that the greater one that is in the world is also in me, then there is nothing in the world that can overtake me. So I live from this, everybody say perspective. And I live with this, everybody say perception. That greater is the one that is on the inside of me. Remember, when Peter is asked this question, there is no indwelling. When Peter is asked this question, there is no infilling. When Peter is asked this question, there is no outpouring. Don't have the time to talk about it today. I'm closing. There are 11 other people with 11 other perspectives and 11 other perceptions. So I want y'all to do your homework. Read John 20. This side. I want y'all to do your homework. Read Matthew 15. This side. Read it. 16. Matthew 16. Thank you. Matthew 16. Read the chapter. In 15, Jesus says, "Who do men say that I am?" So here's where I close. How many people in this room have responded and have already accepted the call of God on your life to salvation? Raise your hand. Good, thank you. Put your hands down. Is there anybody, y'all don't even have to get up, stay seated. Is there anybody in this room that has felt the call of God to salvation? The call from the life that you were living to the life that God has promised you could have, but you had not yet responded. Raise your hand. You have not responded. You have not accepted what Christ has done. You have not responded to the call of God to salvation. Raise your hand. You know that you felt in your being that there was a better way for you to live and you needed to know how to do that, and you did not respond to that. If you're here today, raise your hand. Is there one? Good. No. Let me tell you. Brother right here. God bless you. God bless you. We're going to talk to you in 1 second. Thank you so much. So now, the Bible says no man can come to God except they be drawn. I'm back in the lesson. Peter did not have to follow Jesus. But there was something in him. Let me just y'all do know Peter didn't have no Bible, right? So y'all do know Peter had no clue who this dude was who start talking all of this wonderful stuff that sounded too good to be true. Peter responds to the call. You ought to thank God that you responded to the call. And here's where I close. Here's what Peter says. Peter says, truly, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Here's what I want y'all to catch, and here's the lesson, and I'm done. Those of us that enter into relationship, those that respond to the call, are those of us who recognize that Jesus is the one who saves our soul and who saves our sanity. And how does Jesus do it? Jesus does it by not only by dying, but he does it by giving us his words, by giving us his wisdom, and by giving us the ways in which we are to live our lives. So when I ask you the question, who is he? And what is he to you? I want you to be able to answer that question for yourself. But beyond answering the question for yourself, I want you, oh my God, to be able to testify to those who have not experienced Jesus in the way that you have. And here's where we all get to celebrate. We get to celebrate in this. I recognize that Jesus is the one who has been resurrected. And not only do I rejoice in the fact that Jesus has been resurrected, I rejoice in the fact of knowing that not only is he a historical figure that defies history, but I know he is the supernatural Savior that defines my destiny. I recognize that Jesus is not just a natural phenomenon who walked the earth for 33 years. But I recognize that Jesus is the supernatural phenomenon who once lived and died, yet he lives again. So on today, let's celebrate that Jesus Christ was not only, he was not only transfigured, he was not only transformed, but he was also translated into glory. And then from glory, he'll be translated back to earth, but not just in a physical representation. But he shows up every day in you. He shows up every day in me. He shows up every day knowing that I'm the one that now bears the marks of the resurrection. I'm the one that bears the resurrection of consciousness. I'm the one that is now the testimony that I went down a bound sinner, but I was raised free from the bondage of sin. And because I am in relationship with Jesus, there is no good thing that God will withhold from them that walk
upright. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor sitteth in the way of sinners, nor standeth in the seat of scorners, but his delight is in the law, and does he meditate day and night. What you meditating on? I'm meditating on that the one who came to fulfill the law is the one that lives inside of me. I'm getting out of here, but Jesus on the inside, working on the outside. Who is he to you? What has he done for you? Who is he to you? And what has he done for you? You ought to praise God for transforming your life. Praise God for changing your life. You ought to praise God for picking you up, turning you around, placing your feet on solid ground. Anybody, everybody, somebody, praise him because you know who he is. Praise God for who God has been to you. Give Jesus the praise for how Jesus has shown up for you. Come on, everybody, lift your hands, open your mouth, and begin to thank God for being your Savior. Who is he? And what has he been to you? Who is he? And what has he been to you? Praise him for it. Worship him for it. Come on and lift up the name of Jesus.
Standing, I'm closing. I'm done. Everybody on your feet. If you can stand, please stand. You can stand, please stand. If you can stand, please stand. Who is he? And what is he to you? We know what Peter has to say. But what do you have to say? I want us to take from this lesson, this message on today, that your perception and your perspective adjusts. Watch this, don't miss it. With performance. How you act for God and how God moves on your behalf is based on perception and it's based on perspective. Whew, my God. Lord, thank you. Holy. Listen, if Jesus, I'm going to stretch, but y'all, come on, stretch out here with your faith. Stretch out here with me with your faith. If Jesus can feed 5,000 plus men and women and children, why we gotta worry about where our next meal is coming from? It's because our perception is off
and our perspective is off. If Jesus can heal the sick and raise the dead, and I'm dealing with an infirmity in my body that God created, if there's a woman who can spend all that she has and press her way through a crowd of people who are looking at her and her condition and not care, just so she can connect. Who is this Jesus that you serve? So here's where I close, and here's the challenge for you today. Here's the call to action. This message is a call to action. I'm gonna pick it up next week. On today, one question, because we all respond to knowing that we cannot do life successfully without God. That's why we come to church, that's why we pray, because we know we can't make it on our own. All the theology that we've been given has caused us to believe that we are no good on our own. I'll talk about that another day. But what that means is that when we reach the extent and we exhaust all that we have, that's where our supernatural steps in to supplement where we're naturally depleted. Since the same spirit that raised God from the dead resides in you, it will quicken your mortal body. And I need you to catch this. In other words, the Holy Ghost is going to work in your body. Lift your hands and say, Holy Ghost, work in me. Say, Holy Ghost, work on me. Say, Holy Ghost, work through me. Say, Holy Ghost, work as me. And God, for individuals that are in this room that are committed to doing your will, to doing your work, and limited by physical conditions, touch their bodies now. The spirit is ready, but I feel the Holy Ghost. Lift your hands and say, Lord, touch my body so that I can do your work. Touch my body so that I can do your will. Touch my body so that I can walk in your way. Lift your hands and say, Lord, touch my body. Who is he and what is he to you? He's a healer. Jesus is a healer, but the world don't believe it. Jesus is a healer, and he heals all the time. Heal the sick. Raise the dead. There's no reason to be afraid. Jesus is a healer and he heals all the time. Type in the comments, be healed, be healed, be healed. Look at your neighbor and tell him, be healed, be healed. Look at your neighbor and tell him, be healed, 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 be healed. We're getting ready to get out of here. Wave at somebody on the other side and say, neighbor, I'm talking to you over there. Tell them, be healed, be healed. Look at your neighbor on the other side and say, I'm talking to you. Those of y'all watching online, be healed. Be healed in your mind.
Be healed in your body. Be healed in your emotions. Be healed in your spirit. Break it down, break it down. Thank you, I appreciate that. Listen, I feel this in the Holy Ghost. I'm done. I didn't plan on doing none of this today. That's why I wore a t-shirt. I am asking God for each and every individual that is committed to being an evangelist. That means you are going to go and testify to somebody about what God has done in your life. And since God did it for you, Sister Josephine, high five me from your seat. Testify that God is a healer. She's been healed. She's a healer, a walking miracle. Testify. My prayer is for those that are willing to be evangelists, which means if you're not willing to be evangelist, it just doesn't apply to you, and it's okay. It's no disrespect. It's no disregard. I still love you the same. Come hug me after church. But for those of you all that are willing to be evangelists, I'm asking that God continue to do what God has already done for you. And I'm looking at people in this room that knows God is a miracle worker. High five me from your seat and say, God is a miracle worker. High five me from your seat and say, God is a healer. High five me from your seat and say, God is a deliverer. You high fiving me and you saying it because you know it. We believe too much. But one thing you know by experience is that God can and God will. Hath God not said it, and shall it not be done? So I'm praying that God touches your bodies so that you can evangelize. Watch this. Woo! Thank you, Holy Ghost, and I'm done. So that you can evangelize like you've never evangelized before. Watch this. There are two areas that all of us need miracles in, and this is what I consistently pray for. I want you intercessors, I thank God for each, all of y'all, Sister PJ, Sister Elder Shanice, and Elder Sonia, and Dr. Mother, I thank God for all of y'all. You all keep interceding for what you all, those of you all that are spiritually gifted and going to the atmosphere, I thank God for you. Let me tell you what I pray for, two things for this church. I pray for abundance, and I pray for healing. Pastor Bill, you ought to be praying that souls get to, I ain't got to pray that prayer. You know why? Because Jesus already prayed that prayer. Read your Bible and argue with me at dinner. I would tell Elder Knox to raise his voice, but he's been preaching. That's all right. Jesus already took care of that. I'm praying that God's people in this community, in this body of Christ. Yeah, I said it. I feel like Isaac Ellis. Yeah, I said it. I said it. I don't. Y'all pray for, I pray for two things. I pray that the people that God sends to this ministry and that are in this ministry. I'm like John, just like I'm like Jesus. Talk about that later. I am Jesus. Y'all get ready for that one. Stay tuned. Look at your neighbor and say, I am Jesus. I'll tell you about it later. You'll get it. Talk to you about it. Y'all stay with me. We going there? You going to jump? You going to jump? I'm going to hold you. If you jump, I'm going to hold you. All right, then we going there. Check this out. Beloved, I wish that in King James, thou mayest prosper. That's how y'all know I went to King James on you. Thou mayest prosper. What I tell y'all I pray for? Abundance. And be healthy. What I told y'all I pray for? That y'all are healthy. To do the work of the ministry.
so that we, not me, so that we, not I, so that we can edify the body of Christ. So there's some of you in here on today, and I'm done, I'm closing. Put up the giving on the screen. Put up the giving on the screen. The five ways to give. I'm done. I'm done. Five ways to give. Don't miss your blessing. I don't have a number for you today. I'm not even going to ask the Lord to give me one. I'm not going into the Spirit for it on today. I'm going to ask you to do what's in your heart. Do what's in your heart. Do what's in your heart. There you go. Thank you. Now get your microphones. I like that. I like that. Y'all come on, close us out. I'm going to pick this up next week. Next week. Next week. Next week. Next week. I'm going to talk from this topic. Next week, I'm going to talk from this topic. Unless the Lord changes between now and Sunday. I'm going to talk from this topic. My topic is going to be, don't lie to me. That's what I'm going to talk about there. Don't lie to me. Don't lie to me. Durin, I need to come back next Sunday, man. I'm going to talk about don't lie to me. All right. Don't lie to me. Don't lie to me. Don't lie to me. I'm going to talk about it next Sunday. Don't lie to me. Look at your neighbor and say, don't lie to me. Don't lie to me. Don't lie to me. Don't lie to me. I'm going to talk about it next week. Put a gift in your hand on today. I'm going to say this to you, brother, because you raised your hand. But I've seen you here enough to know. I'm not going to question your salvation. That's not my job. That's for you to know between you and God. Right? What I am going to tell you is the fact that you raised your hand means that the prayer and this service and the thank you, Holy Ghost, this was for you. I don't know what's going on in your body. I don't need to know. I'm not going to go and ask the Lord to show me. Because God knows, and that's all that matters. God knows and you know. But what I am asking God to do is whatever is going on is supposed to lead to something much worse. That's blocked. It's done. If it don't get better, it ain't gonna get no worse. Tell God thank you. Now we gonna believe God for better. So that as God heals your body, matter of fact, as you continue to testify about God being a healer, God's gonna keep healing your body. And you are going to be an evangelist in your latter years like you've never been in the years before. Lift your hands and tell God, thank you for healing me so that I can evangelize. The one who healed. I told y'all, she told you this morning, I ain't got a cane today. I ain't got a cane today. And you ain't gonna have one tomorrow. Tell God, I ain't gonna use one tomorrow. Come on, tell him thank you. Jesus is a healer. Jesus is a healer. If you've been healed, lift your hands and say, God, I thank you for healing me. The one you heal. Come on, if you know he's a healer, lift your hands and say, healer. Come on, say, healer. The one you heal.
The one you heal has come to honor.
If you've been healed, come on, lift your hands and just honor the Lord in the room. Come on, lift your hands all over the building. We're getting ready to go. Stand to your feet, everybody. We're getting ready to go home.
The one you healed.
Has come to honor.
We honor you today, God, in this place.
The one you healed has come to worship.
Let's get baskets on the door. Break it out. Let's get baskets on the door. Listen, don't miss this opportunity to be blessed. All right? Don't miss this opportunity to be blessed. Don't miss this opportunity to be blessed. You all have heard me intentionally emphasize what God can do and what God wants to do in the area of our finances. On your way out, they've got the baskets on the doors. Brother Cersei, Brother Curtis, our amazing ambassadors, we thank God for you. You all know how to give electronically. Make sure you do that. A delayed seed is a delayed harvest. Don't miss your blessing. I want to say this before we go as a matter of importance. This Tuesday night, 6 p.m., I need to see y'all in the building, in the room. TNT will be live, will be online, but I need to see you in the room. This Tuesday night is our Buy Back the Block. All right? I've said this before and I'll say this again. We're not just going to declare and decree for the supernatural to take place. I would be deficient as a leader if I left you there. So we're going to give you tips. We're going to give you tools. And we're going to give you strategies on how to make it happen. I'll talk more about this on Tuesday night, but I need to see y'all here, 6 p.m. I cannot declare, I cannot decree. You all cannot have faith without action. Look at your neighbor and tell them your faith needs feet. Bible says like this, faith without works is what? So you can believe God until you blew in the face. But how about you believe God and you come out? All right, this is not by commandment, this is by permission. I'm just going to say this to y'all. This is for those of you all who really believe. Thank you, Holy Ghost. This is for those of y'all who really know, not just believe. Because what believers will do is say, I have faith, and they'll stay home. Believers will say, I have faith that I can buy a home, and I've never owned one in my life. But believers will stay home. Knowers will say, I have faith, and they're going to show up. What y'all don't know is there are opportunities that are available that you can take advantage of, but watch this. Matter of fact, thank you, Holy Ghost. I rebuke the spirit of fear, and I rebuke the spirit of ignorance right now in the name of Jesus. What's been keeping our people from experiencing abundance has been fear and ignorance. Because we won't take advantage of opportunities. You don't think you can own a multi-unit property. And you're too afraid to go find out what it takes. Show up Tuesday night so we can help you out. Because guess what? You think your credit is that bad? Let me tell you what God will do for you. Credit that's bad enough will still be good enough. I ought to have 17 witnesses in here that can high five me from your seat then say you got something right now that you know your credit shouldn't have let you get. And you ought to tell God, thank you. So again, you're missing it. You're in fear and you're in ignorance. So come out. Your credit just might be good enough, watch this, for you to own a multi-unit property that yields enough revenue to pay for the rent that you've been struggling to pay. You can have four families taking care of you and your family. Look at your neighbor and tell them, stop being afraid and stop being ignorant. All right, Elder Knox is back there. Amen. If you got a credit card, debit card, you can see Elder Knox. If you're giving your envelope, hopefully you scanned the QR code. All right, I'm getting ready to pray and I'm gonna dismiss and we're done. Any questions, any comments? Did I miss anything? I'll try to get my announcements. Don't forget, October 27th, we're kicking off Holy Healthy Weekend. October 27th, Saturday. October 27th, Saturday.
April.
Oh, April. I said October, right? I'm sorry, y'all. I'm in consecration already. I'm in 21 days of consecration. I'll bring that back to you later. But I thank y'all, really. I'm in 21 days. I've been over there already. I had to come back. And then, Sunday, October 28th, Elder Sanders is going to be back with us. Holy Healthy. Holy Healthy is going to be in full force. I tried to get Dr. Buckles, Elder Foster, Sister Paulette. I tried to get Dr. Buckles, but he just couldn't. I said, we're going to do the whole weekend. So if he show up Saturday, we're going to thank God he surprised us. Amen. Elder Sanders will be here on Sunday. Evangelist Paulette will be going forth leading the session on Saturday. Closing out this month, and then we're moving into Mental Health Awareness Month, the month of May. God, I thank you for all of those that have joined to worship with us on today, in person and online. I thank you for the word that has been released to us, and I thank you that you will continue to show yourselves to us strong, show yourselves to us mighty, continue to reveal yourselves to us so that we can continue to testify of your goodness and your mercy. And so that when people ask us who is